innovation within teams. So most of the times, as through with my, this presentation also, I'll also try to illustrate the fact that most of the times we have the UX process in place. But where we fail to do create awesome products all the time is we are taking these little decisions. As Gaira also mentioned, we, those decision making is where we start losing out on the final outcome. Most of the time when the project starts, the aspirations of the project are big. We want to revolutionize the market, disrupt the way things are done, change the world, and make it the next big thing. We are designers, and we get excited about this idea in the morning. That is what we wake up to do. We want to create that change. But somewhere down the line, it becomes very hard to achieve. And as we go ahead, we'll see this is more or less how a product cycle looks like. You start with a grand idea, and somewhere along the process, with every decision being made with our teams, the essence gets chipped away. It has transformed into some form of that idea, which is good if you are lucky, but it is not that great. It is not the vision we started out creating. As Jean-Paul Sartre said, we are our choices, and so are our products an outcome of all our choices. And this is a choice not just of the UX team, but of all the people in the team. The different departments getting together to make those little choices. And yes, diversity is an important part of it, but diversity of perspectives is what we need to bring together. We practice a lot of empathy to understand our users, but not even 10% of it to understand the people who are taking the decisions within the organization. If only we can understand the different perspectives from the business team, the product team, the engineering team, to make those decisions, because they are the people deciding finally what the users are going to see. And then we can create a synergy between these teams to solve things together, to actually solve the real issues, to get insights and have solutions which can actually solve for the ecosystems. More often than not, the products are not just an app or a website that we have built. It has a starting point from where what real problem is trying to solve to the final end point, what it is solving. And if you look at the iPod, we can all agree it was a great product. It changed the market in a way that UX became a profession thanks to Steve Jobs and Apple. And iPod was, if you look at the design of the dial, it is not an intuitive design. I mean, I would not look at it and say that, oh, I have, for until now, I have been going forward and backward to play my music. Suddenly, there's a circular dial. That's not intuitive. What intuitive is what I can predict what it is. It wasn't predictable. But why it became a success? It became a success because there was already an ecosystem of music being online, available in an iTunes store. And here was this device which I could carry in my pocket and actually take it around. I could listen to thousands of songs at the time, now millions. But thirdly, we don't take enough risk. Imagine a discussion, if I go back to the previous example, imagine a discussion happening where the designer goes up to the business team, say that, hey, I have this design, it's a circular model, and this is going to be the navigation structure. They will be like, okay, but what does the user start saying? Like, have you done the A-B testing? Like, yeah, it is, and they're excited about it, but we don't know yet, we have not tested it out. And imagine if at that point the designer does not take that risk or does not take the leadership to convince them about this idea would never see the ray of light. It will go on into the rejected ones, as with many others. The problem with our profession is not that there's lack of ideas, but there's a lack of leadership. The ability to actually catch a glimmer of hope in something and put all that we have behind that idea to make it work. Go out there, test your ideas, learn what users are talking about it, and come back. Come back and convince the other teams. That's what will create these awesome products. And at the last, all I even want to say is that we have to stop thinking like a designer and become like a design crusader. Go out there and make the change. If you believe there is an idea which we need to work on, we should take every step, make justify it for the users, justify it for our teams, because at the end, that is what the product is going to be like. If you have any stories regarding this, please share it with us. Use the hashtag Design Crusaders and share it with us, tweet us, and let us know what your stories are like. Thank you.